Rule number one, keep your refrigerator and freezer within the proper temperature ranges. There are several procedures you need to follow in order to adhere to rule number one. These include the following. Make sure that the refrigerator is properly connected to a reliable and secure power source. Optimize the unit's performance with proper placement and internal organization. Maintain and calibrate the proper temperature indicators. Keep a log for the unit. And finally, make sure you have a contingency plan with established protocols in place in the event that vaccines must be moved to backup storage. First, let's discuss the power to the unit. Your refrigerator should be in good working condition and must have power at all times. To avoid any disruption to the power, you should install a plug guard, similar to this one, over each outlet. This will prevent the plug from accidentally being pulled out from the wall socket. You should also post a sign at the wall plug warning others not to unplug the unit. At your circuit breaker, mark the switch that controls power to the refrigerator and freezer, and post another sign warning personnel not to turn off this breaker. There are some simple steps you can take that will optimize the performance of your refrigerator and freezer and help keep temperatures within the appropriate range. For example, proper placement of your refrigerator and freezer is important. You need to have good air circulation, so place your unit far enough away from the wall to allow for unobstructed airflow. Also, check the coils and vents on the unit to ensure that they are free of dust and vacuum them regularly. Inside the unit, be aware that you should never store vaccines in the door of the refrigerator or freezer. The temperature in the door is not stable. Instead, vaccines should be stored in open containers in the center of the refrigerator, away from the walls and floor of the unit to allow air to circulate freely around the vaccines. You should also be sure that the top shelf of the refrigerator is not positioned too close to the freezer vents, which could expose your vaccine to freezing temperatures. Vaccine placement in the freezer should also be in the center of the freezer, away from the walls or the freezing component. As you might expect, it's important that you and your staff avoid frequent opening and closing of the refrigerator and freezer doors. Obviously, this can cause fluctuations in temperature. And by all means, never leave the door to the refrigerator ajar. Make sure the door is closed securely each time. There are some additional steps you can take to help maintain proper temperatures in the refrigerator and freezer. For example, it may be helpful to remove bins and drawers from the refrigerator and place bottles of water in that space. You should also place bottles of water in the door. These help store and retain the cold temperature. This same principle applies to the freezer. By adding extra cold packs, you can help keep the freezer temperature stable if there is an unexpected power failure. Monitoring the temperature of your refrigerator and freezer is a critical responsibility. In order to monitor the temperature properly, you need high-quality, accurate thermometers. Although there are different types of thermometers, it is important that the thermometer you use is certified. Certified means that in addition to the calibration that all thermometers receive during manufacturing, a second individual calibration is made. This second calibration is made against a reference standard set by agencies like the National Institute of Standards and Technology, or the American Standards of Technology and Measurement. This certification, which is different from the manufacturer warranty, is recorded on an official report from the manufacturer and provided with the instrument when purchased. Make sure you have the certificate from the manufacturer confirming this calibration. Keep a certified thermometer in the refrigerator and another in the freezer. The thermometer should be placed in the center of the compartment, away from the coils, walls, and floor of the compartment in order to get a true reading of the temperature. You must check the refrigerator and freezer temperatures twice a day, once in the morning and once before you leave at the end of the workday. Record the temperature on a log sheet or calendar kept on the refrigerator door. Temperature indicators and around-the-clock monitoring systems may be used to alert staff, but they should not be used as a substitute for twice daily temperature readings and documentation. As a refrigerator ages, you can track recurring problems or identify how long a problem has existed. It is important that you keep temperature logs on file for at least 3 years, unless state statutes or rules require a longer period. Twice daily temperature monitoring is not just useless paperwork. If the temperature in the refrigerator or freezer is out of range, you must take action immediately. It is essential that your vaccine storage is kept within proper temperature ranges. The temperature in the refrigerator should be between 36 and 46 degrees Fahrenheit, or 2 to 8 degrees Celsius. The temperature in the freezer should be less than 5 degrees Fahrenheit, or minus 15 degrees Celsius. What should you do if you discover an out-of-range temperature reading? You must take action immediately. The first action step is to notify your supervisor. Someone, in addition to you, needs to be aware that there may be a problem with your refrigerator or freezer. Also, notify your local or state health department. The next action is to determine the cause of the problem. There are several factors that can cause temperature deviations. For example, the doors may be opened too often, perhaps because the unit is being used to store food and biological products. It's extremely important that all staff understand that food or drinks should never be placed in a refrigerator or freezer used for vaccine storage. Other problems might include the thermometer is inaccurate or not working properly. The refrigerator or freezer may need to be repaired. The power is being interrupted. Or the freezer temperature is so low that it is affecting the refrigerator temperature. Regardless of the cause, immediately address the issue and fix the problem. If you are unable to remedy the problem or make the appropriate repair in a timely manner, then you must enact the contingency plan you have outlined. You need to specify the steps to follow for transporting the vaccines to backup storage. You will also enact your contingency plan in the event of a natural disaster, such as fire, flood, or hurricane. This contingency plan should be posted on or near the refrigerator containing state-provided vaccine. It's important that all members of your staff who are involved in vaccine handling are well-versed in this plan. Their prompt action can save your clinic hundreds of thousands of dollars in vaccine losses and will ensure that your patients continue to receive reliable vaccines. Let's take a look at the key components of an effective vaccine contingency plan. First of all, you must identify a responsible person to enact the contingency plan, as well as a knowledgeable alternate if the primary person is not available. Include home, office, and cell phone numbers. Identify an emergency storage location where the vaccine can be transferred. Establish a contact person at that location. Verify their approval and provide their home, office, and cell phone numbers. Ideally, you should choose a facility that has an alternate source of power, such as a hospital or grocery store. This is especially important when faced with a power outage from a storm or other natural disaster. If possible, choose a location that is within a reasonable distance from your clinic so that transport time is kept to a minimum. In addition to these procedures, you and your staff should follow some specific steps in preparation for and during transport that will help safeguard the vaccine. Note the time of the emergency situation or power outage. Note the temperature of the refrigerator and freezer when the emergency occurs. Specify what containers should be used to transport the vaccine and how these containers should be packed. For example, you may choose to use ice packs and separate them from the vaccine with bubble wrap or crumpled paper. Inventory the vaccine as it's moved into the transport container, being careful to indicate the number of doses of each vaccine and the expiration dates. Keep a thermometer in the transport container and note the time and temperature when you place the vaccine in the alternate storage. This provides a timeline for how long the vaccine was at a less than ideal temperature. And last but not least, contact your state or local health department to inform them of the emergency. Be prepared to provide the temperature of the vaccine, the amount of vaccine, the expiration dates, and how long the vaccine was exposed to out-of-range temperatures. If you do not recognize a problem when it first happens and take corrective action immediately, then your patient could receive compromised vaccine. This could result in having to recall individuals for revaccination. This can be expensive. And more important, it can undermine the trust patients have in vaccines and your practice. By adhering to a solid contingency plan, you can make sure that your vaccine supply stays safe and endures an unexpected disaster.